Elon Musk, he spent the time drafting, I guess, like a brief to accompany a lawsuit against the website Media Matters. He tweeted, "The split second court opens on Monday, X Corp will be filing a thermonuclear lawsuit against Media Matters and all those who colluded in this fraudulent attack on our company." To be clear, you don't have to wait until the court actually opens. You can digitally file before that. He has 1,000 lawyers. How does he not know that? I also, this is a small thing. I just find it to be funny. Can we bring up that graphic once again? It's just the weirdest little thing. Because like he's promising to sue a journalistic organization for criticizing him or for even just publicizing what he says. And he's the richest man in the world with a massive staff that can help him. That is a screenshot of a Word doc that he is typing up at that point. And I know that because the cursor is still visible after speech. What a weird, weird man he is. But anyway, the idea is that Media Matters, which we actually did it last week. We talked about the results of their study showing that ads had been placed next to anti-Semitic, basically Nazi content. He's saying they lied. It's a scam. And it's such a lie that they should be sued for that. And not just civilly, by the way. He wants criminal investigations of Media Matters for publicizing the fact that ads were posted next to Nazi content. And I know that because he replied to Stephen Miller, who said fraud is both a civil and criminal violation. Elon Musk said, interesting, both civil and criminal, ... to which a right-wing attorney general says, my team is looking into this matter. The attorney general's team is looking into the fact that Media Matters ran an article detailing how extremist content had ads served on it that nobody involved in the story disputes the facts of. Elon Musk in that says, yes, Nazi content had ads placed next. It wasn't much. It wasn't a lot compared to all of the tweets. Yeah, but it was there. Like, and they just said that it was there. And so he is enraged by this and he wants to destroy Media Matters. And of course, the right wing is going to be perfectly in favor of this, despite pretending to be anti-elitist, anti-status quo, anti-establishment. They're in favor of the richest man in the world who single-handedly owns a social media site, destroying an outlet that tries to hold the wealthy and rich accountable. What are your thoughts?
Elon Musk is just going to do what everyone who is losing, who has lost the argument, who's a failure, continues to do despite all of the advice, which is to tweet through it. Mm-hmm. And my dude, my guy, stop. Don't tweet through it. Just stop. Because he is hemorrhaging advertisers. And so he's going to pick a fight with Media Matters that points out why he's hemorrhaging advertisers, specifically actions that he's taken, tweets he's put out there, but also the fact that, like, guys, you can't put a tweet out there. And honestly, let's talk about anti-Semitism. If you're Jewish, like, you can't tweet without like 5 different people replying to you going like, oh, you're Jewish. And you're like, I know. What? Like, it's really, really disgusting. I mean, more so than it always was. But it's like, no, my dude's just going to keep going. He's going to try and sue people and point fingers and blame everyone but himself.
Yeah, 100%. And I want to run through, like, this is all a dodge from the real concern. He is pretending that Media Matters should be the star of the story because he doesn't want to be, for once. And by the way, you mentioned him tweeting through it. You may not know this, but I sometimes have to go and find tweets that people have sent to put on the show so that you can see them. Do you have any idea how hard it is to find a thing that Elon Musk tweeted? Because he tweets every 2 seconds. One day of his tweets took me 20 minutes to scroll through.
Sure.
He's the CEO of 6 companies. He's tweeting right now. He never stops. I would love to see someone take a timeline and just post all of the times he tweets. Anyway, look, he's angry, as you said, because he's hemorrhaging advertisers on Twitter. And so Disney, Apple, IBM, Lionsgate, a number of different companies are pulling their advertising. That's like, people are pointing that out now, but they've had advertising issues since he took over for a lot of different reasons. And they're pretending that it's Media Matters' fault, and they're pretending that Media Matters lied, but they're not even really showing it. This guy, who's apparently an executive at Twitter, says the way they did this was they created accounts and followed accounts and then refreshed the timeline more than most people do. And that's how it's a fraud. You're showing that they did it and it happened. You might say it's not perfectly representative, but you're saying they didn't lie. It actually happened. And the bigger issue for them is that this has nothing to do with the advertisers fleeing, or at the very least, there are a million other reasons that they might flee. Media Matters also showed how content with white nationalist hashtags gets ads placed next to it. Other people completely unrelated to this are showing how there's literally ads being placed for non-consensual deep fake AI porn generation.
Holy crap.
This is not new. The website has become a den of anti-Semitism, homophobia, transphobia, hatred, and the place is rotting from the head down. You don't need to refresh your feed 50 times to know what this site is like. All you need to do is follow Elon Musk, who notably, before the Media Matters thing, did his "you have said the actual truth" thing, where he claimed that Jewish people are trying to flood America with minorities to replace the population. At a certain point, perhaps Disney and Lionsgate don't care so much about the ad place, but they care about the fact that the guy who represents the entire brand is an obvious raging anti-Semite and conspiracy theorist. Mm-hmm. And if you need another demonstration of that, by the way, I want to go to this. So we will go to graphic 11. The libs of TikTok woman decided to, and this is just viciously cruel and disgusting, dead named Ari Drennan, who I believe has been on the damage report. Ari is trans, and that somehow is like a revelation of these people and also proof of why you shouldn't trust anything they write. Says your reminder that Ari Drennan is a man who just pretends to be a woman. She's one of the most disgusting humans in America. And said advertisers are taking their orders from a mentally ill man who dresses up as a woman.
Christ.
All Ari did is show what is on the site. And to that, Elon Musk says, wow. Not wow, like you or I might, like, wow, what the hell is wrong with you? Wow, as in, yeah, you shouldn't listen to anything this journalist says because the journalist is trans and that by itself means they're untrustworthy. I don't know. Maybe this has something to do with why brands don't want to advertise on Elon Musk's playpen.
Yeah, I'm waiting for us to go. Like, John, you've already left and gone to other platforms. And yeah, like, honestly, Zuckerberg looking totally A-OK after all this. It's so clear what this is. And I just, you think about these grifters and you're like, how much hate do you have? Like, do you need a hug, Chaya? I'll give you a hug and a makeover, girl, because my God, stop. Just because, are you mad? Because actually, Ari Drennan is cute AF? Like, come on now. Come on. You pissed? You jealous? Live your truth. Get a hug. Move on with your life. And everyone really should move off of this platform.
Yeah, this free speech platform, by the way, reminder, free speech. Also, reminder, the entire point of posting that is to try to destroy Ari Drennan. At the very least, to drive Ari off of Twitter, because I cannot even imagine how many vicious death threats and threats of rape and God only knows what else. Doxing, perhaps people showing up. That's what this is designed to do. Now, Ari is incredibly strong from having experienced this for a very long time. When you actually challenge the powerful, you get attacked. So Ari posted, thank you to Chaya and Elon Musk for sending so many new followers my way today. But it's got to be difficult, the toxicity that must be flowing Ari's way. But what else do you expect from Elon Musk, a guy who has tried to cover for his comments about being pro free speech by at all turns trying to nuke from orbit anyone who challenges entrenched power and wealth? Check out the Damage Report podcast each day, wherever you get your podcasts, whether Pocket Casts or Stitcher or iTunes. You can join me as I give you the news and stories you want with a range of co-hosts and interview guests jumping in on the fun each day. Again, that's the Damage Report, wherever you get your podcasts. And if you get them at iTunes, don't forget to rate and review. Sometimes I'll read them live on the show.